वेलकम स्टूडेंट, लेट अस कंटिन्यू विद दिस सेकेंड लेसन दैट इज द लेट अस यूज द ग्रैटिक्यूल. हियर वी आर गोइंग टू रीड अबाउट द ग्रैटिक्यूल. ओके, फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट वी विल रीड. When we talk about the various places, regions, rivers, roads, regions, roads, we are actually talking with the reference to the earth, the location of the place, the extent of the region and the extent of any linear feature can be described precisely with the help of parallels and meridians. So here are the parallels and meridian. So look at this picture. Whole earth is divided into longitudes and latitudes. Okay, look at this earth. Longitude and latitudes are imaginary lines. Okay, so look at this. This is latitude and this is a longitudes, all the longitudes. So this is southern hemisphere. The equator and the prime meridians are labeled in degrees. So the white lines in these pictures are shown the degrees. Okay, and we have to identify the values with the meridians and parallels. Here are some examples which we have to put in the in this picture. Okay, while describing, so the first here to verify the descriptions with the help of a map or a globe in the school, that is the first point of this is the while describing the locations of a place, we need to consider only one parallels and one meridian. That is, Delhi is located at 28°36'50" north. Okay, so here is the earth and we consider the only one line of latitude and only one line of longitude. So we can say that the Delhi is located 28°. Here this is Delhi 28°, and 36 minutes 50 seconds north. latitude and the 77 degree 12 minutes 3 seconds east longitude. So when we consider about the latitudes, we locate the place into north and south. So we can identify a Delhi in a latitude by using the latitude that it is placed into 28 degree 36 minutes and 50 seconds north. Okay, because of north and south hemisphere. And while Delhi, while we consider the longitude, the Delhi is located at 77 degree 12 minutes and 3 seconds. So let us continue with such examples. For describing the extent of the region, we need to consider the two parallels and two meridians at the extreme end of the region. For example, the extent of Australia is described as a 10 degree 30 minutes south. So where is Australia? This is Brazil. Here. Ten degrees 30 seconds. We are going to actually. We have, I think, on the last page we have this. For describing the extent of the region, we need to consider the two parallels and two meridians at the extreme end of the region. For example, the extent of Australia is described as 10 degrees 30 minutes south to 43 degrees 39 minutes south latitude. So because this Australia situated in the southern hemisphere, so the its extent also lies in the southern hemisphere. So at the end of the calculations, there we put a symbol of capital S, and the first we have a 10 degrees means the Australia's that particular point is making a angle with the center of the earth. So we consider that center of the earth with the 10 degrees. Okay. Then the 30 minutes is the extent from the latitudes So we consider that it is a 30 minutes, and then if we go into the deep calculations, we can calculate into seconds also. Okay, here Australia. Here Australia lies between the 10 degrees 30 minutes south to 43 degrees 39 minutes south latitude, and 113 degree east through the prime meridian. Australia is situated at the eastern side, so we shows that the Australia is lied between 113 degree east to 150 degree east longitude. So the Australians extend we calculate through latitude and longitude. For describing the extent of the linear feature like a river, road, etc., we need to consider the longitude and latitude of their terminal point. So terminal points means the starting of river and where he meets to the sea, that point. For example, the river Nile in Africa originate in Lake Victoria, flows north and meet Mediterranean Sea near the city Alexandria in Egypt. The location of Lake Victoria is about to 0 degree because it is situated on the prime meridian. Okay, 0 degree 45 minutes 21 seconds latitude, and 33 degree 26 minutes 18 seconds east from prime meridian. So it extends from 0 degree to 33 degree. Okay, 33 degree longitude. Similarly, the location of Alexandria is 31 degree and 12 minutes north. Location of Alexandria and 29 degrees 55 minutes and 7 seconds east longitude. These latitudes and longitudes are considered to describe the extent of the river Nile. This extent is from 0 degree 45 minutes south, 0 degree 45 minutes south latitude, and 33 degree 26 minutes east longitude, origin of the river Nile, to 31 degree 12 minutes north latitude, and 29 degree 55 minutes east longitude, up to the mouth where it meets with the Mediterranean Sea. So this type of graticules through which we come to identify the locations on the earth. So let us use this type of graticules into practice. Here are which we look at the picture of Brazil. Brazil is a very large country. It has different types of biomass. And the greatest river, which contains a dense forest, that is the river Amazon basin. It is originate at the here. Okay, here is the place through which river Amazon started, and it goes through the two different countries, that is Peru and other, and meet to the North Atlantic Ocean. So the extent of the Brazil is from the eighty degrees east to 80 degrees east to 40 degrees west. So we are where that complete information. 15%. So the next point is the important parallels and meridians. So here is the picture of the North Pole, South Pole of the Earth, 66 degrees and 30 minutes is the region, that is the Antarctic Circle, and the prime meridian has a 90 degree with an equator. Here is the picture of the North Pole, that is area of a very slanting rays, duration of a day more than 24 hours. So here we have 24 hours, and the area of a slanting, that is day to 24 hours, this is actual day is happening through this line, that is the after completion, after leaving the area of the Antarctica and Antarctica. And third is the area of a perpendicular rays. So here is the line that is the perpendicular to the equator. One minute, it can't be seen properly. So here it lies, okay, from this side up to this side and then this side. Okay, here we have perpendicular line. And another line, that is lies and calculate as a perpendicular line, that is the Capricorn. Here we have perpendicular line, okay. And here also we have perpendicular line, which is lies at this location on the earth. So here are the earth is divided into parallels and meridians. The first is the Arctic Circle, which is 60 degree and 30 minutes north, 180 degree longitude. Total longitude is the 180 degrees, while 23 degree and 30 minutes north, it is a tropic of Cancer, and at the equator we have 0 degree or 180 degree of longitude. Then Tropic of Capricorn, that is 23 degree and 30 minutes south. So here we have important circles. Let us get acquainted with some important parallels and meridian. So the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn, which have us at the same length from the equator, that is the 23 degree and 30 minutes north and south respectively, and the parallels 66 degree 30 minutes north and south equator is also important parallels. Here we have consider that regions as Arctic Circle and Antarctic Circle respectively. Depending on the season, daytime can be greater than the 24 hours in the areas at the polar circle circles and poles. The maximum durations of the sun appearance in the sky can be about 6 months at the pole base on the season. During this period, sun continues to move in a spiral way on the horizon. So student, we will stop here and continue with these lessons into the next lecture. Thank you.